Hello everyone, I am Rupali Meshram. Today we are going to study Standard 5th Environmental Studies Part 1. Today we are going to see the second chapter, Motions of the Earth. Let's see. Rotation. Try this. Take a top, spin it and observe its movement. When we will spin the top, at that time, around that stop which spins around an imaginary lines are formed. The turning of the stop is called rotation. Rotation is performed around an axis. With the point, the top will start rotating at its one axis, that the spinning and the imaginary lines will be seen on the top. The top turns around itself. Any object that turns around itself actually turns around a certain imaginary line. The turning of an object around itself is called rotation. And the imaginary line around which it rotates is called the axis of its rotation. So as the earth which rotates around its axis is the earth's rotation. Earth's axis is inclined. And also the rotation, when the turning of any object around itself is called rotation, and the imaginary line which will be formed on the top or that rotating material object which it rotates is called the axis of its rotation. Here you can see the axis atop and the rotation process and the imaginary lines which are the colors. This will be the imaginary lines which will be seen when the top will rotate, but it will seem less when it is still. The earth's rotation. Try this. Take a globe like the one in the picture and spin it. Note the line around which it rotates. Now take a plumb line and hold it close to the globe as shown in the picture. If you cannot get a plumb line, tie a long thread to an eraser and make one. Here you can see. In this way, one globe you have to take and a plumb line you have to hold close to the globe as shown in the picture. Here you can see the North Pole, axis, Northern Hemisphere, Equator, Southern Hemisphere, South Pole and plumb line. So these all are the parts of our globe. So as when we will talk about the North Pole and South Pole, when the axis points, you will see the line when it will join the North and South Pole, that will be axis. Northern Hemisphere above the equator, that will be Northern Hemisphere. Below the equator, it is Southern Hemisphere. You will see the plumb line and the earth axis are at an angle to each other. That is, the earth axis is inclined. The earth rotates with its axis inclined like this. The line NS in the picture shows the earth axis. That is N and S. That is North Pole and South Pole. That shows us the axis. It passed through the center of the earth. So as from where it is passing from the center of the earth. The points N and S are called the poles of the earth. So as the point S and point N, it will be known as the poles of the earth. N is the North Pole of the earth and S is the South Pole. So as N means North Pole and S means South Pole. So here, if you will try after performing the experiment which is showing rotation of the earth, if a plumb line is held close to the globe, the plumb line and the earth's axis make an angle with each other. The north and the south pole, the one end of the axis of the earth is called North Pole, while the opposite point is called South Pole, that is S. The line joining North and South Pole, that is N and S are North and South Pole. and they are also called an axis of the earth. What is equator now? The imaginary circle present exactly between the north and the south pole on the surface of the earth is called an equator. Once again, I will repeat, the imaginary circle present exactly between the north and the south poles on the surface of the earth is called an equator. Let's see what is hemisphere. If a circle were drawn around the surface of the earth exactly in between the north and south poles, it would divide the earth into two equal parts. This imaginary circle is called the equator. When a line will divide the earth into two equal parts, that imaginary line is known as equator. The two equal parts it makes of the earth are called the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere respectively. Try this. Stand a candle in the middle of a large table. Draw a big circle around the candle. Place a globe at any point on the circle. Light the candle. See that it is dark in the room. Suppose that the candle is the sun. Observe which part of the globe gets the sun's light and which one does not. As when we will draw a big circle on a paper, and we will place on the table, keep a lighted candle at the center of this circle, place a globe on any point of the circle and let the room to be dark. So as when you will dark the room, the light falls on the side, that side of the part of the globe which is facing to the candle is well lit, while the other part which is away from the candle is the darkness. It means that where the candle's light is falling, that is daytime. That is, as we are imagining, that candle is a sun. So as the candle which is facing the globe, the part which of the globe is facing, that will be day, and the part where the candle's light is not falling, that is the night part. Means the dark part will be night in that regions, and where the portion which is lightened, it will be the day time in that all parts. Observe which part of the globe gets the sun's light and which one does not. The well lit part of the globe shows day. So as just I told you, where the candle's light is lit, that part will be day, and where the part is dark, where the candle's light is not reaching, that part will be night. Day and night is seen at a time on the earth. In some parts of our world, there is a daytime and night time. In some places at same duration, if it is today 5 p.m. it means that this is the evening time, but in some countries this will be a morning time or it will be a night time. Now look at the globe from the direction of the north pole. Turn it anti-clockwise. This is how the earth rotates. That is, it rotates from west to east. So as our earth that moves from west to east, as the earth rotates, its different parts come into the light of the sun one after the other and turn away from it also in the same order. It means that if we will talk about the rotation of the earth, the movement of the earth around its axis is called rotation. When the part of the earth that faces the sun has day, while the other part which is not facing the sun has night. The earth rotates from west to east. During its rotation, the different parts of the earth come into the light of the sun one after the other and also turn away in the same manner. Sunset and sunrise. Try this. Stick a red bindi on the globe. Set up the previous model of the globe and the candle. Turn the globe anti-clockwise. Note when it is sunrise, noon and sunset at the location of the bindi. Yes. one new activity they had given. We have to place a bindi on the globe at one particularly place. And as like the globe and the candle activity we had done, same setup we have to do. And we have to move the globe into anti-clockwise. And we have to decide that on the bindi, where the bindi is there, at what situation, when it will face the sun, what time it will be morning or it will be sunset or it will be sunrise or it will be night time, what timing it will be or what climatical situation it will be in that place, that we have to decide. After placing a red color bindi on the globe, we have to set up the experiment in the same manner as the previous one. Using the light of the candle, perform the rotation of the globe, and we can understand sunrise, noon and sunset by this experiment. So as from this experiment we can, after one sunrise, note when the next one occurs at the bindi. You will see that this happens when the earth completes one rotation. That is, when it makes one complete turn around itself, this period of time that the earth takes to complete one rotation is called a day. A day has two parts, daytime and nighttime. Our simply day and night, for the purpose of measuring time, we divide the whole day into 24 parts, each of which is called an hour. So as we divide sunrise, noon and sunset are caused due to the rotation of the earth. During the rotation of the earth, the time period from one sunrise to the next sunrise is called one day. So as when the bindi will complete one rotation, then we can say that one day is completed. Day and hour, the period of time that the earth takes to complete one rotation is called a day. Each day is divided into 24 equal parts of the purpose of measuring time. This one part is called an hour. It means that 24 hours is divided into 24 hours, or we can say 12 hours day and 12 hours night. But sometimes, as according to the climatical situation, it changes. So as day and night, these are the two concepts. As one day, when the earth will move from east to west or from west to east, one day will be completed. So in this way, few points we had discussed today in this chapter. Motions of the earth, in that we had seen the earth's rotation, the north and south pole. What is the north and south pole? You can see in this diagram, the north pole, they had written south pole, N means north pole, S means south pole. And the line which divides the earth into two equal parts, that is only known as equator. It is an imaginary line. And the above part of the equator, it is known as northern hemisphere. And the remaining part which is below to the equator, that is southern hemisphere. So as northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, it is divided by the equator line. These are the imaginary lines which helps us to understand the concept of earth. Again, the hemispheres, that is two hemispheres, northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere, north pole, south pole, these are the concepts. Rotation of the earth we had seen. Under this earth's rotation, when the earth will rotate itself, so one rotation will be done, that is when it will rotate itself, one rotation will be completed, that is one day is completed. While doing like this only, when he will start rotating a sun, and when it will complete one full rotation of a sun, 1 year will be completed. That concept we are going to see in the next period. So as again we had seen here, the day and hour, 24 equal parts are divided for measuring the daytime, and we are 24 hours are divided into a single hour. These all concepts we had seen today about a year we are going to see in the next period. That's all for today. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for my latest updates. Thank you.